Okay, so the first thing when you go to the eYield website, you've got two main services, yeah, day trading and swing trading. And the difference between day trading and swing trading is in terms of how long we keep the trade open. Okay, so if you do day trading, it's like what I call intraday trading. Okay, it's the same thing. Day trading, we in general will keep the trade for a few hours, maybe a day, maximum 2 days. Sometimes we take a trade, and if we can't keep, you know, can't close it at the end of the day, then we'll go over to the next day with the same trade. So that's okay. Okay. However, if I look at swing trading, it's like we target the bigger moves. Okay, so it means that if I expect a move in the market that will last maybe a few days to maybe a week, then that is a swing trade. It means the position will be kept open for many days. Sometimes it can be quick, it can be 1 day. In general, it's like many days. Okay, so those are the two main services. And if I go to day trading, the first one, okay, so day trading here, there is an example. I'm going to focus on that example. Okay, so this is an example, not a real trade. So basically, when I send an alert, an intraday alert, you can see I specify a level to buy or to sell. There is a target price and a stop loss and a confidence level. So the first thing is that when we do day trading, we use the FTSE 100 cash. Okay, all the trades, FTSE intraday, they are on the FTSE 100 cash. Okay, this is day trading. So when I say we buy at 69.50, that is a limit order. Okay, so when you get the alert, because some people get the alert by email, some people get the alert by SMS, and both email and SMS. When you get the alert, it doesn't mean you have to buy now. No, there is a level. So here, for example, we buy at 69.50, it means that you have to wait for that level to be reached before buying. Okay, this is what I call a limit order. So when you get the alert, you put that into the system. You know, you can put a limit order, you put the level, then you put the stop loss, okay, because the stop loss is, you know, as the name suggests, you know, when the stop loss is hit, then the trade closes at a loss. And then there is a target. And the target, when the target is met, you have to close the trade, because I'm not going to send another alert, you see. So that's why I put a target, because when the target is met, you just close the trade. And I don't wait for my alert, because I won't send one. And then there is a confidence level. So the confidence level, this is something to do with volatility, because when the market is volatile, there is a higher chance that the stop loss will be hit. Because here the stop loss is only 40 points. So with day trading, the stop loss is always 40 points. It's not a lot, but this is what, you know, traders like. They like a tight stop loss. And this is what I call a high leverage strategy. High leverage because there is a stop loss. So people will bet a lot more than, you know, if you were trading without a stop loss. So the confidence level, we've got here 70%, but it can be 60%. In general, 70% is high probability, 60% is low probability. I mean, there is no, basically when you see 70%, you just trade normally, as you would do. Like for example, if your size, you know, is 10 pounds per point, I'm talking about a spread betting platform, for example. You know, if your size is like 10 pounds per point, and you see 70%, then you will do 10 pounds. But if you see 60%, that means it's a bit more risky, it's lower confidence. So in that case, when you say 60%, you reduce your size. Instead of doing like 10, maybe you do 5, or maybe you don't trade. Some people will not trade sometimes. Some people will just focus on the 70% confidence. But, you know, based on the statistics, you can still make money with 60% confidence, but it's a bit more risky, so you have to bet less. Okay, so when I send an alert, intraday alert, that alert remains valid until I send the next alert. Okay, so for example, if I send an alert and you don't hear for me for like until the end of the day, that alert is still valid. It means that the limit order is in the system. We have a limit order, and that limit order will stay in that system until I send an alert to cancel the trade. Okay, so if something has changed and I decide to cancel the trade, then I will send an alert to say cancel this order. If I don't say anything, it means it's still valid. Okay, sometimes I will say buy, like in that example here, 69.50, but the order won't be filled. It can happen. Imagine that the FTSE is trading at 7,000 right now, and you see that alert to buy at 69.50. The FTSE goes to maybe 69.70 and then starts rallying. So it means that the order has not been filled because it didn't get to 69.50. In that situation, okay, the alert is valid. However, if the market rallies to the target, which is here 70.20, and the order has not been filled, you can assume that the order is cancelled. It's cancelled because the target has been met. Okay, so if you get an alert and it's not filled but the price goes to the target, you assume that the order to buy at 69.50 in that example is cancelled. Because in general, what I will do, I will send a new alert. And each time I send a new alert, it's always the latest alert that is a valid one. Okay, so if I send an alert to buy at 69.50 and later on during the day I send another alert to say we buy now at 7,000, that latest alert is a valid one. The previous one is cancelled. Okay? The other thing with intraday trading is that, as I said earlier, we can keep the trade open during the night. Okay, so for example, if we buy, we have an order to buy and that order is filled, but the target is not reached by the end of the day, we will keep the trade open until the next day. Because sometimes the move will not start immediately. Sometimes it will take a bit longer. So that's why we keep it. And the day after, I will send an alert anyway, just to confirm that that trade is still open. The only time we close an intraday trade is on a Friday night, because we don't keep an intraday trade over the weekend. Whether it's a weekend or a bank holiday weekend, we just close everything on a Friday night before 9 p.m. So for example, if you have an intraday trade open and it's Friday night, you have to close it before 9 p.m. Whether or not the target is met, it doesn't matter, we close it. And if we have an order in the system to buy, if we have a limit order to buy, and it's Friday night and this order has not been filled, we cancel that order. We start on the Monday with a new trade. Okay, that is for day trading. So it's very straightforward, as you can see. You've got the buy or sell, target, stop loss, and confidence level. As you can see, there is always the swing trade. There is also some swing trades. And the swing trade, if I go back to swing trading, okay, those swing trades, they are posted on a different website. Because when I was talking about the day trading, they are delivered, the alerts are delivered by email and SMS or email only, depending on which option you choose. But when we do swing trading, the swing trades are posted on a website, which is a Better Trader premium website. That website. Okay, so the trade alerts will come by email anyway because when I post a report, I will, if I go to the FTSE, there are some categories on the right. Okay. When I post I post the report, and the report is posted every evening at about 6 p.m. Okay, so it's called the FTSE 100 forecast. And you can see the trade alert is here. Okay, so basically a trade alert is a bit like the one on the FTSE intraday, because what you have here, you have the a limit order. Okay, this one, you can't see a limit order because it's been filled already. This is why it's written here, we remain short. It's been filled. But normally there is a limit order and then a target and a stop loss. Okay, well, as you can see, swing trading, because the trade is kept for a few days or maybe a week, it's a bit longer term. When we do a swing trading, we use the FTSE future. And here, the FTSE 100 September is the one we select. When this future expires in September, then we'll move to the next one, which is the FTSE 100 December. At the moment, we are doing FTSE 100 September. So as you can see, it's similar, you know, we've got a limit order, target and stop loss. There is no confidence level because here we assume that because as you can see the stop loss is wider, the stop loss is 100 points because on that trade, this particular trade here, we went short at 7,600. So the stop loss is 7,700, okay, 100 points higher. And the target is 200 points lower, 7,400. So we don't use a confidence level because here it's less likely the trade will be stopped even if there is a bit of volatility because the stop loss is wider. Now the difference between the FTSE intraday and the swing trade, with the swing trade, we are going to keep the trade open over the weekend. Okay, so if you have an order or if you have an open trade on the FTSE 100 September, that trade will remain open during the weekend. It's the same thing for the limit order. If there is a limit order on a Friday night, that limit order stays in the system over the weekend. So this is again very straightforward because you've got all the level. Put them into the system where you open or where you buy or sell. You put that into the system, put the stop loss and the target also. And again, you know, when the target is met, I'm not going to send another alert to tell you to close it, you know, because this is done by yourself. You know, you know where the target is. When the price is at the target, you have to close it. Now, when you do the FTSE swing trading, the advantage over the FTSE intraday is that the profits are bigger because we target the big moves. So that is the good thing about the swing trading, is that when you take a position and the market goes our way, we will make like something like 200 points or more sometimes. So that is the advantage of the swing trading. Many people see the high stop, the large stop loss as a problem, but it's not a problem because the profits are large too. So what I recommend you do both. You do the FTSE intraday and the FTSE swing trades. Because, you know, sometimes you go through a period where the FTSE intraday will not work very well because there is a bit of volatility and it's more difficult to make a profit. And while during that time, you know, while the FTSE intraday is not doing so well, the swing trades are doing very well. You know, so by mixing the two, you increase your profit potential. And also over the long term anyway, the FTSE intraday makes money and the swing trades make money as well. So when you combine the two, you make some decent profits. So the way to do it is that you have to bet less on the FTSE swing trades, on the FTSE September, because the stop loss is wider. Okay, so for example, if you bet 500 points on the swing trade on the FTSE 100 September, you can put more on the intraday because the intraday trade on the FTSE 100 cash, the stop loss is only 40 points, so you can increase the bet because the stop loss is tighter. But on the FTSE 100 September, you have to bet less because we've got a larger stop loss. And of course, when you join the services, whether you join the FTSE intraday or the FTSE swing trades, you will get access to the, I've got a traders community, which is an app, it's like a messaging app where we chat about the market. And the advantage of that, that app is that we can exchange ideas during, you know, during the day. If you have a question, you can always ask the question on the app, and you get an answer immediately. You don't need to wait too long. I mean, except if I'm busy, if I'm in a meeting or not available, then you know I can't be available all the time. That's normal, but it's a good way to communicate and to exchange ideas. Now, as you can see, I'm going to show you the traders community in a moment. But when you are on that website, which is Better Trader Premium, you can see that there are other stuff, like, for example, the option, FTSE options. Again, you know, this is something that, you know, if you want to learn about options, by the way, the options are profitable too, they make money. But I think it's more for more experienced investors, more experienced traders. A lot of people are confused by options. If you go to the top here, okay, here you can see that there is a link. In fact, if you go to resources, on resources you will see a link to some guides, you know, on options. Option explain how to trade option. So you can read all that and how to learn about options. And also, there is another one here, trading the FTSE with call option. So again, it's like some information about options. Okay, so if you are interested in option, you can read all that. And then, if you feel that you want to trade option, here on FTSE options, I give my recommendation, what I'm trading myself, you know. So it's all there. Plus you've got other markets also, as you can see, Euro dollar and S&P 500. But my main market is the FTSE 100. So I think that's the one that I recommend. Now, if I go to the traders community, so it's basically it's like, as you can see, it's an app, a messaging app, and it goes on. You can have access to this app on your mobile phone, on your computer. And you can see there are a main group called everybody, and this is where we chat about the market, this is where we discuss the market, like anything about the market in general. It can be on the FTSE 100, the S&P 500, sometimes on cable, which is sterling dollar, or it can be about anything that influences the FTSE 100. And if you are doing the FTSE intraday, you have two groups. You have the FTSE intraday here and everybody. So if you are doing the FTSE intraday and you have a specific question about a trade, an open trade or something like that, you post it in the FTSE intraday group. If you are doing Better Trader Premium and the same thing, and there is a you have a query about a trade, an existing position on the FTSE 100 September, then you post it here in that group. Otherwise, if you want to chat about the market in general, then you use everybody, and you can see here we are chatting about the market, you know. You see, people are asking questions, you know, and I answer their question instantly, okay? So that's the app. And as I said, you know, if you subscribe to any services, whether it's Better Trader Premium or the FTSE Intraday, you will have access to everybody and your own group, okay, which is FTSE Intraday and Better Trader Premium. Now you can see there is another group here called No Stop Strategy, and that one is another service. I haven't discussed that service earlier, but the No Stop Strategy is a strategy that is where I trade the FTSE 100, S&P 500, cable, various markets. In general, not many, like three in general, those three. And there is no stop loss. This is why it's called a no stop strategy. Obviously, because there is no stop, we bet small. There are smaller trades. So that is the difference between the FTSE intraday, the swing trade, and the no stop strategy. The no stop strategy trades are smaller because there is no stop loss. Okay, so if you are interested in trading small amount with no stop loss, then that is a good strategy, the no stop strategy. The way I protect the trade is by hedging, by using the S&P or cable, and making sure that some of the trades are protected by other trades. But if they are not protected, because the amounts are not big anyway, it's not a big deal, you know, if it goes into a loss, because they are not big trades. That's a difference with the other services. Okay, so basically, that's it for today. And if you have any question, you know, please send me an email. But it's a profitable service as long as you are very disciplined. The key to success is discipline. So I always say to people, you know, if you do exactly as I say, you will be profitable. However, if you start picking and choosing trade or not doing everything, then this is where it can be a bit messy. And that's why I always recommend to do exactly as I say. And that way, you will be profitable. Thank you very much for listening, and goodbye.